Let's talk about Lisa Murkowski.
Let
me read a little bit of her statement. Yeah. And, John, I want you to, you know, walk. There are now two Republicans who will vote in favor of witnesses, Mitt Romney and Susan Collins of Maine. Lisa Murkowski will vote no, which is significant. Here's one of the things she says. Given the partisan nature of this impeachment from the very beginning and throughout, I have come to the conclusion that there will be no fair trial in the Senate. I don't believe the continuation of this process will change anything. It is sad for me to admit that as an institution, the Congress has failed. It has also become clear some of my colleagues intend to further politicize this process and drag the Supreme Court into it. She's very tough on this issue of the Supreme Court and the Chief Justice specifically. It sounds like that may have been her reason. She didn't want a 50-50 tie, which would have dragged the Chief Justice John Roberts into this whole thing. As a result, it's going to be 51-49.
It's kind of a kitchen sink statement in the sense that, look, you know, if she voted for witnesses, she would have put the Chief Justice in a bad position. Step back. We don't think he would have voted, but she would have had the tie. But she criticizes the House. Check. She criticizes the attacks on the Supreme Court. Is that Rand Paul for trying to expose the whistleblower and putting the Chief Justice in a bad position? Or is Elizabeth Warren for proposing a question? Or is it both? She's clearly not a fan of the president's behavior either. The interesting part to me is she made this decision, which will make her Republican colleagues happy because it will get the trial. We now know the trial will be over. It might go a few more days, but it won't be a few more weeks. But she apparently, according to Manu Raju and others on the CNN staff on the Hill, are among those pushing McConnell to take a few days here, to not rush the vote, so that senators can have time to speak. Susan Collins, who's in a tough re-election battle, working with her, according to Mano's reporting. That part is fascinating to me. Do these senators, how many of them? Lisa Murkowski, Susan Collins, wanting time to speak and explain themselves? Doesn't surprise me, given the history. Their sort of semi-maverick role, if you will, or outlier role sometimes within the Republicans. But how many others? Are there others? You read Marco Rubio's statement, Jake, earlier today, where he, you know, does take a shot at the president. He's not hugging the...
Vaguely.
Not a tough one. I get it.
It's really between the lines.
Right.
You really have to squint.
Right. You have, and so does he just want his statement to stand for it and let this go? Or do other senators, other Republican senators, want to go to the floor? Does Lamar Alexander want to go to the floor and read his statement into the record, where he does say, I don't like what the president did here. I just don't think it's impeachable.
Rob Portman from Ohio, Republican senator, actually used the word wrong. The W word, not just inappropriate, but wrong. But Senator Santorum, you know Lisa Murkowski. You have respect for her.
I do.
Tell us, it was hard to tell where she was going to land if you just went by the questions she asked during Q&A period, because she would ask a question that was tough for one side, and then she would ask a question that was tough for the other side, just on the matter of new witnesses.
Yeah, I think what Lisa's statement reflects is what I think any member would be going through who's in her position, which is she knows her vote isn't going to be decisive. And so you actually do consider the ramifications of your vote, given that the fact that your vote isn't going to make a difference. But I think, as Wolf pointed out, the putting the Supreme Court on the line, and she does, she kicks the House pretty hard in this statement. She kicks the Senate pretty hard. And she's saying, you know, we've already sullied the House. We've already sullied the Senate. The president has done his job of sullying the executive branch. The last thing I want to do is now bring the Supreme Court into this mess, and I'm going to end this. And so you can say, well, she's diverting, she's dodging. But Lisa's a pretty straight shooter. I think she's a very thoughtful person, and I think she's just saying, end the mess.
I think this would have been completely valid had she put this statement out a few days ago.
No.
What was strange about this, and what is not going to sit well with people, is that she was undecided, was contemplating it. This bombshell of a New York Times story comes out, and then she comes out and says, "Oh wait, that." You know, we don't need witnesses. We don't need to hear more. The timing of it.
Well, she also said
is tortured.
But she also said that the House's articles of impeachment were flawed and rushed. So maybe it wouldn't have mattered to her anyway.
I don't see anything in that statement that is even vaguely critical of President Trump, though. I don't see anything.
No, and I read this in my initial reading, the last statement about the Supreme Court, as specifically to Warren. Now, that may be because I'm a Democrat, but I thought that was a pretty clear...
That's what I thought. But I didn't think it was... Alan, to talk about the importance of this moment for senators to speak. Because, you know, for a lot of us who are watching this, the vote is really all that matters. I only remember one person speaking on the floor of the Senate during the Clinton impeachment, and that was Joe Lieberman, who people thought might vote to convict, but ultimately was talked out of doing it. And he gave a statement in which he really talked about the agony of watching a fellow Democratic president go through and put the country through what he did based on the corrosive behavior of Bill Clinton. Why is it important for these people to give statements about how they voted?
Well, unless they change the actual rules, you're not going to hear any senator speak. The best they can hope for at this point is that they can have statements submitted for the record. Mm-hmm. It would take a resolution or a motion to suspend the rules to have senators actually have their voices heard during the trial. Right now, the best that the Democrats can hope for is that their case continues to be made by the House managers.
So, John, what are you reporting then? I mean, because you said that they want to speak. Are you saying that McConnell's going to suspend the rules to allow them to speak?
You heard Schumer. They're trying to cut some sort of a deal. I have a couple emails from people on the Hill, and I was looking at the reporting that Manu has filed in as well. There's some conversation going on that Senator Durbin said that it's McConnell who wants to push the vote back until Wednesday. Mm-hmm. The White House, is, by all of our CNN's reporting, is asking this to be done before the State of the Union. They're willing to wait out the weekend, but they want it done on Tuesday. And this is a back and forth. And you heard Schumer, a little prickly there at the end. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to take any questions. He said there's no deal. So obviously they would have to reach an accommodation of some sort of a deal. And I guess Alan would know this better than me. Would they have to suspend the trial or put the trial in recess for them to give speeches, or would they just have to have a new resolution that said we're going to have a speaking period?
Well, they could get unanimous consent.
Yes, that's what
to permit senators to speak and dare their colleagues to object.
Right.
I mean, what colleague is going to object to that?
I'd heard plans that they were going to give every member 10 minutes.
15 minutes.
We're getting some new information. Dana Bash is up on Capitol Hill with Manu Raju. What are you guys learning?
That's right. We can add to the conversation what we've been hearing here in the halls of the Senate about the notion of when they're going to have a final vote and the question of senators wanting to have their time to make their case on the Senate floor for the record in a public way, because they've been sitting there for a very long time. We've been hearing the trial, but they haven't been able to speak. There's a whole bunch of to-ing and fro-ing going on behind the scenes about when they will potentially take the final vote. And that statement by Chuck Schumer that we just took live, that was really telling.
It really was, because he said we have not reached an agreement, him and Mitch McConnell, about the final process to get to a vote. And what we're hearing, what your sources are telling you, what I'm also hearing, is that there's this discussion now to have the final vote on Wednesday. Now, that is much different than what we were hearing last night. Republican leadership was pushing hard to get this done late tonight. And one big reason why, as you were saying, the members have been sitting around. They want a chance to express themselves. I've been told that Senators Lisa Murkowski, Susan Collins, want to have about the same amount of time that occurred in the Clinton trial, those deliberations that occurred. Those happened behind closed doors, about 3 days' time. They want to have about the same amount of time, but that will be in a public session. Now, they're also running into some logistical issues because the State of the Union is Tuesday. The Senate floor will be closed for part of Tuesday.
The Iowa caucuses are on Monday.
So Mitch McConnell is proposing a Wednesday time to have the final acquittal vote. But the White House really wants this done Tuesday so the president can announce in the State of the Union he has just been acquitted. It just doesn't seem that it's possible at this point.
And that's really the key. The key is it's not now that we know where Lisa Murkowski stands, and since last night you're reporting on Lamar Alexander, we know, unless there's something that we really don't expect, that there won't be a vote to allow new witnesses. So we don't have any expectation that the president will be convicted unless, again, something dramatic happens. So now it's all over but the when. And, you know, for people out there wondering why is this an issue, it is an issue because it is history and because these senators want a chance to sort of say their piece. And the fact that this is a real negotiation going on between the Senate Republican and Democratic leader is really telling. And the fact that the Iowa caucuses and four Democratic senators are sitting there saying, can I please get out of here?
Yeah.
But they can't really say that because they have to show that they're doing their duty.
And a lot of Republicans, too, that we have not heard a lot of Senate Republicans speak their mind about exactly where they come down on these issues. A lot of them have said, we're jurors, we're not going to deal with this. One Senator, Ben Sass, who has said virtually nothing, he came up to us and he told us a lot of Republicans agree to what Lamar Alexander said. A lot of us, he speaks to a lot of us. Well, then I asked him, well, do you think the president acted inappropriately? He would not answer that question. We'll see if he decides to do that. And other senators decide to express their views if they have the time to speak.
Yeah, because remember, as we've been saying since the beginning of this trial, a lot of it is about the votes, but so much, maybe even more right now, because we are in an election year, is about persuading public opinion. Back to you, Wolf and Jake.
All right, Dana and Manu, thank you so much.